In this section, we're going to go over smoking in the iCombi Pro and our smoking accessory, the VarioSmoker. So today we're going to smoke a brisket. We just salt and peppered that. And we're going to show you how to load the chips in the VarioSmoker and some of the different options you can use with the VarioSmoker. So we're just using dry wood chips. We do not want to soak these wood chips because we're really getting a very, very low amperage. So it's just, if we soak them, it really extends the amount of time it takes for those chips to start smoking. So we just want to fill these up with a wood chip like this, right? Just nice small chips. You can get them in pretty much anywhere. We try to avoid big chunks of wood just because they really don't fit well, and dust, sawdust, because it tends to want to blow around the cavity with the fan running. So those size wood chips work really good. We're using hickory chips today. Oak's also a great one, apple wood. Anything you'd like to as a smoking wood is fine. So the VarioSmoker has three different parts. We've got the power source, which comes with a kit that mounts to the side here. We've got the box itself. And then we have the connectivity from the USB connectivity from the power source of the VarioSmoker to the iCombi Pro. And this lets the unit and the VarioSmoker communicate and actually gives us some smoking options on the screen. Now, you do not have to use this connectivity part. If you want to do some manual programs where you're setting the smoking options, you can just use the VarioSmoker as it is without connecting it. But we're going to connect it because we want to use our smoking options. So I'm going to go ahead and connect these two units together and plug our outlet into our power source, and then plug it into the VarioSmoker. Now, I'm also going to go ahead and plug our box in, and the box just snaps into this little port right here. That just snaps into place. And as soon as I turn on the VarioSmoker, and as you can see down here in the lower right-hand corner, our smoking options menu setting has appeared. So we're gonna go here, and it shows the options we have. We've got brazen smoking, hot smoking fish, hot smoking poultry, hot smoking side dishes, hot smoking turkey, low temperature smoking, that's for what we use, low temperature cooking, low temperature roasting for prime ribs and stuff. So if you wanted to smoke a prime rib, this is a beautiful way to do it overnight. But we, and their last option is just smoking, which is a cold smoking option. It runs at 86 degrees, so you can cold smoke anything you want to before you go ahead and start a different cooking process. We're going to use the smoke and braising and smoke setting. So it says, as you can see here, it says, please put the VarioSmoker in the cooking cabinet, which I've done. Now I'm gonna set my options. I'm gonna do with the probe because we're gonna take this brisket up to 205 degrees under the braise setting, then slowly bring it down and hold it. I'm gonna do without any additional color because of that smoke that's adhering to the meat. We're gonna get great color on this. And we need to set what we want our hold option to be. So we're gonna hold this somewhere between 160 and 170 degrees. It's gonna bring that up to temperature and then slowly bring it down and hold it for us overnight. The other option we need to set is our pre-smoke. So each one of these lines represents 20 minutes. So 20, 40, 60, 80, 120. So I'm gonna pre-smoke for 120 minutes to really get a lot of smoke into that meat before we start cooking. So once I've got my settings in there, the unit's gonna ask me to shut the door so I can, we wanna shut the door so this wire is not in the corners, any of the corners, just because it puts undue stress. So you can close it with the wire above, or you can just do it out the side. I'm gonna do it with the wire up top. It's asked me to place the VarioSmoker in, which I'm already doing, and now the unit is preheating. So it's gonna preheat and pre-charge that smoker before it asks me to load. So our iCombi Pro is alerting us that it's ready for us to load our brisket. So we're just gonna place our brisket on a grid shelf here with a granite enamel catch pan underneath. We're gonna open the door. We can see our smoker has started to charge. We're getting a little smoke in the cavity. We're gonna go ahead and load this guy. And we're gonna wanna put our probe in just to the thickest part of that meat. So I'm gonna go ahead and insert my probe. Make sure my wire is back up top, not in the corner. Shut the door, and we're off to the races. Now, at this point, we can go home. This will smoke overnight and hold for us, and we'll have a beautiful smoked brisket when we get back in the morning. So we have a brisket here that we actually did last night to show you. So see how nice that that nice bark that it created? And we did that without color because we've got the smoke. So we're gonna split this deckle off from the flap. And then give our brisket a little slice here. So this is our flap side. See how nice and moist that is? Not dried out. Very tender. So this is a great way to utilize your iCombi Pro for some smoking items. And if you have any further questions about using the iCombi Pro and the VarioSmoker, please feel free to call us on the Chef Line. We're here to take your calls.